Assalamualaikum guys. And now you are watching Okay guys, today I want to share with you how to learn English in 3 easy way without using any Grolia or Luwafo products, but still can be great in English. This is the free method to learn English, and you only need things that surround you seriously. But before that, I want to say thank you to my colleague Mr. Hamzah for giving these 3 methods. He is a great English lecturer, and that's why he can come out with these 3 methods. Anyway, sorry, I cannot put Mr. Hamzah photo here in order to respect his privacy. What? Do you think that I do not know how to respect others? Huh? However, let's start with these 3 easy methods to learn English. First method, create words from long words. For this method, you only need to choose one long word and try to create other words from the long word that you have chose. For example, I choose word sophisticated. So, what words can I create from this word? So, it can be cat. Okay, from the letter cat over here. Or it can be so. Okay, from the letter. Try to create words as much as possible from the long word that you have chosen. From that word, you can enrich your vocabularies and make it easier for you to write or communicate in English. Woo! Second method, use verb plus adverb and adjective plus noun. You can use this method while you are doing something. Let's say you are walking, which is walking is the verb, and it may go or it may sound like this: walk slowly. Walk quickly. For adjective plus noun, the example may look like this. When you see a car, and you may say out loud like this: beautiful car. Or you can use adjective like this: ugly car. So the next time you are doing something which is verb, or you see something which is noun, try to relate it with an adverb or an adjective, and try to speak out loud things or action that you have done by using an adjective and also an adverb. Handsome guy. You too. Handsome guy. The third method. Look at your watch. Usually, when we want to mention the time, we'll be always say like this: it's 9:05, it's 12:30, it's 2:40. 45. Actually, this is an informal way to mention about time. How about we learn the formal way to mention about time? Can we? Let's say on your clock, the hour hand is at 9 and the minute hand is at 1. You should mention it as 5 minutes past 9. Alright, how about we look at another example? Okay, let's say the hour hand is almost at 11 and the minute hand is at 9. As 15 minutes before 11. So do you get it? Beside that, if the minute hand is at 3 or 6 or 9, there are other ways to mention this kind of time. Okay, so let's say the hour hand is at 10 and the minute hand is at 3. We can also mention it as a quarter past 10. Or if the minute hand is at 6, we can mention it as half past 10. And when the minute hand is at 9, we can set it as a quarter before 11. So, there you have it, 3 methods that you can use to improve your English. Try to discipline yourself to try these 3 methods and always use it every time or everywhere you are. Because this kind of method is really easy and really helpful to improve your English. Okay, even though it's very easy, like use an adjective, noun, a verb, or verb, and just by mentioning the time, this kind of method is really help to improve or enrich our vocabularies. Do you still need Grolia or your phone to learn English? No need lah. If you think this video is helpful, please share it with your friends so that we can improve our English together. Together is not like this. Together is like this. This is together.